Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. I would like to tell Your Honor and the court a little bit about Jamie's and my life. First, my wife, Kim. Kim was full of energy, excitement, and life. Her infectious smile and vibrant personality were so inviting to all. It welcomed you. You wanted to be with her, be part of her. Everyone who came to know Kim adored her. Whether they were fellow hospital employees, townspeople, the guys who worked on her car at the garage, or just the people in the supermarket, everyone smiled at Kim's energy and kindness. She gave so much to everyone she met, you just couldn't help but smile back or hug Kim. Kim was a mother. She and Jamie were inseparable. It was more than the usual mother-daughter bond. They were like one. Kim was a warm, affectionate mom who deeply enjoyed spending time with her daughter, and Jamie deeply enjoyed spending time with her mom. Kim loved Jamie eternally. Kim was the best wife a man could have. We were soulmates, and we loved each other unconditionally. Kim took great pride in providing a warm, loving home and did an amazing job of taking care of Jamie and I. She was a loving daughter, a sister, an aunt, a niece, and a great friend. It makes me sad, this trial is how we will know and remember Kim Cates. For she was so much more than this tragic ending. If you had met Kim, you would want her to be your fellow worker, your PTA member, your neighbor, your workout buddy, or just your best friend. Kim was beautiful, and she will forever remain in our hearts, and her spirit will always live on in each one of us who were so blessed to have shared in her life. For Kim was about life and living. Next, I would like to talk about my beautiful daughter, Jamie. It is not known what future impact this event will have on Jamie's life. She has had to witness more evil in this world than any human being should ever be made to bear. She has already persevered many hours of surgery in her young life as a result of this crime, and still has many more to go. But I am certain that the physicians will be able to diminish the many physical scars she will carry with her forever. However, the emotional scarring Jamie has endured is immeasurable and unknown at this point. Friends and family will continue to surround her with love in the hope that the tremendous emotional burden she now carries can be lightened by all who love her. Now I'd like to talk about what an amazing girl Jamie is. After the 12-hour surgery last year, Jamie was placed in the intensive care unit, and during one of her brief periods of being awake those first couple of days, she told me what happened to her mom, and we had a good long cry together. She then told me she was disappointed about missing her kneecap testing. This was all while having her mouth wired shut. This is a testament to what an incredible, strong girl she is. While grieving the terrible loss of her mom, she was already trying to put the pieces of her life back together. Jamie was back in school part-time after 3 short weeks, made up the work missed, and has maintained straight A's ever since. She also played lacrosse this spring, field hockey this fall, and wants to learn to play ice hockey this winter. While not being as fast on her feet as she once was, Kim's spirit, tenacity, and love for life run strong in Jamie's veins. I would like to talk a little about me and the impact this murder has had and will forever have on my life. Kim and I had dreams, hopes, and aspirations like any family, and all those are now shattered. She was my soulmate, my best friend, my companion, and with one phone call, early on a Sunday morning, all those hopes and dreams were lost. My ability to perform my job at the high standards I hold myself is no longer possible. Prior to Kim's murder, I worked full-time, performing an important job for the men and women who protect our nation, a job I love. To do the job right required substantial travel, something that Kim and Jamie understood and supported. I now work part-time so I can care for Jamie in any way she needs me, can no longer travel for work. Others have had to step up to fill in for me in a situation that grates at me every day because I care deeply about them and the mission they're trying to accomplish. It all seems of such little importance now, given my wife's sacrifice. Now I would like to talk about family. Kim won't be there for all the special events in Jamie's life, such as getting her ready for the prom, taking pride in her graduations, helping plan her wedding, and supporting her during pregnancy and childbirth. Jamie and I will forever miss Kim, but we still have each other and we still have family. The shape and dynamics of that family are different, as others have stepped up to fill the huge void that losing Kim has left. Jamie still has mother figures in her life, and I still have very close confidants. The members of our family, while not connected by blood, have a very special emotional bond with us, a bond that I think many families would envy. This family is made up of people from our town, the surrounding community, work, and the school systems. They all play critical roles in allowing Jamie and I to continue to heal as well as feel loved by a family unit. Our family will survive the senseless act and thrive again. Next, I would like to express some thanks. I would like to start by thanking the members of this jury. This was an emotional trial, and I'm sure at times it was very difficult for them to remain objective. I sincerely appreciate their courage in fulfilling their civic duty and the compassion they showed with this verdict. Next, I would like to thank the state's attorneys, Jeff, Pete, and Lucy. Each of you did an outstanding job laying out the evidence in this case and presenting it in a clear, concise manner. I know each of you feel very passionate about this trial, but you maintained a very professional demeanor throughout. Each of you epitomized the highest standards in your profession. I would also like to thank the Attorney General for the support and importance he personally placed on this case. Simple words can't express the appreciation our family has for Jennifer Hunt, the victim's advocate for the New Hampshire Attorney General's office. She has been with us every step of the way since the murder of Kim and the savage attack on Jamie, and I can't express how important she has been for Jamie and I. Her guidance, sympathy, compassion, and genuine caring nature have made a huge difference in our lives over the last year, especially during the early morning hours of October 4th, 2009. I'd like to thank all the first responders, particularly Sergeant Furlong and Officer Wells. Without your quick reaction, my little girl would not have made it. I also sincerely appreciate all the investigators, detectives, and forensic specialists from the New Hampshire State Police Major Crime Unit. The thousands of hours you dedicated to this case allowed Jeff and his team the ability to put on the best prosecution possible. Thank you, Your Honor. Your court staff and the staff from the Sheriff's Department have been very kind to me, my family, and my friends. I would like to express my appreciation for all the support from Mount Vernon, the local community, and across the country. All of the kind thoughts and prayers help Jamie and I heal a little more every day. To my close friends and family, words cannot describe how grateful I am for all your support. You are all amazing people, and Jamie and I are so fortunate and privileged to have you in our lives. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Children's Hospital of Boston again. The care and support given Jamie and our family is truly world-class. I would like to thank CPI and the Bray family for helping us get Dutch, our newest family member. He's an amazing animal. I would also like to thank my employer, BAE Systems. I am very lucky and proud to be a member of such a caring and supportive organization. My final thanks is to the media for their continued respect of my privacy during this very difficult time. I truly understand that you have a job to do, so the restraint shown is appreciated. As devastated as the last year has been, this remorseless act of violence has made our families and communities stronger. In response to the question, so how is Mount Vernon doing, a friend wrote, the simple answer is, we're doing just fine, thanks. And we are. We all get up every day and take care of our kids, go to work, pay the bills, deal with our share of the struggles of daily existence, because life, as cold as it may sound, goes on. The murder of Kim and the savage attack on Jamie has pulled our small, close-knit community closer together. We now know that together we can survive the most difficult circumstances. For the parents and school officials who have watched the events of last year unfold, I sincerely hope that we come away from these horrific acts with some lessons learned. While it has been suggested that a miraculous something that would have prevented this tragedy is difficult, if not impossible, to find, I really think that we as a community should work diligently to come away with some key indicators that can be used in the future to identify kids in trouble and to help them before another heinous act occurs. Going forward, Jamie and I are focused on living the life Kim wanted for us. To the murderer in this courtroom, this upcoming sentencing is not justice. My only hope is that very soon, true justice finds you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.